Debes brindar amor para después pedir. Hay que perdonar para poder seguir.
On the HMV label, B9477, Paris in My Heart for the Lisbon Story, sung in French and English by Jean Cavall. Enjoy. Played on the Melody 115.
Happy songs of love were sung. City of my heart, for you I ever hunger. I only close my eyes and then there's Paris in my heart again. It needs very little to make me aware of something I thought was gone. A letter from Paris, a voice on the air, a record of Jean Sablon. And suddenly, to my surprise, I find there are tears in my eyes. In my heart, forever gay, lingers like a dream of yesterday. Every year in spring, when I hear music playing, there's Paris in my heart again. All her trees in bloom, the bois the same, drifting through the gloom, a dance we pray. And because I find the magic still remaining, there's Paris in my heart again. I can see her cafes beaming and the bicycles go drifting by. Then by a bridge, two lovers dreaming, and the lights against an evening sky. Paris in my heart, forever young, where my happy song of love were sung. City of my heart, for you I ever hunger. I only close my eyes and then there's Paris in my heart again.
Jean Cavall, enjoy, and what better way to celebrate the use of this beautiful French Melody 115 machine. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Well, hello everybody. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to a very chilly afternoon on Sunday, the 27th of September, and it's only 12 degrees. And you can see I've got a really warm jumper on, so a cashmere in this, and also a warm shirt. And the last video I made, I think I was in a t-shirt actually, but today the weather has really turned over the weekend, and it's now coat time and warm stuff, so I've only got my shorts on today. So yeah, anyway, today's a bit of an update. I've just played you a really lovely record on that beautiful machine, the Melody 115 LY, the French machine. I played Jean Cavall, and I really love Jean Cavall. I can't find a lot about Jean, but he sings a song from, about Paris, and so from the Lisbon Story, and it's just so wonderful. It just sounds, and it sounds really nice on that machine. So I brought the record out so here, just so you can see. It's one I got on eBay some time ago, I think. Actually, I've still got the papers in the back. It's really very, very nice. And I thought it was a good celebration for that machine being back in use. And it's a firm favourite in my music room office, stroke office in the house. So I just thought I'd play that too as an intro, really. Today I'm going to talk about the Sony MHE-EX50, I'll give it its proper title, which I've been playing with. And if you remember rightly, I had to order some new belts for it, which I've done. I'll talk about those in a second. And then I just want to also just give a shout out to a really lovely guy who runs a channel on YouTube called Revolution, Gramophonic Revolution. His name is Paul, and he's got very few viewers on there. He's well under what I've got. I've got just over 1,000 people subscribed to my channel, and thank you all for doing that. That's really lovely, because it's really nice to have that patronage from people, and think, and also thank you everyone for those amazing comments that I've received, saying that they like the way I do things, and not to change anything. I'm not changing anything, really. It's just I thought it would be good to up the ante a bit, and but I'm not going to change anything, no. But it's always good to review, and knowing that you are still followers of this channel, which has been going over 10 years now, a decade I've been doing. And if you go right back to the very early days, it was before HD came in. And, so I look a bit fuzzy around the edges. Probably a bit younger, actually, to be honest. So thank you for that. But Paul he's a really lovely guy, and he does some amazing. He's got some really lovely machines. He's got the HMV 501, which is a radiogram, which I really love. Plays 78, and also he's also got some other gramophones there that he uses, and he's got the sort of format that I've adopted in talking about the record and the number before you play it, which is pretty quite nice. So I've given him I've commented back on his channel to say that I think he'd do well to actually put his face on the channel like I did. You get used to people commenting, and in the end you take the dip and off you go. So yeah, I just thought it'd be nice to say that to him, and I've done that today, and I hope he appreciates that. And there's also some other channels which are new guys coming on, talk about cars and stuff, which I think is really nice. Some really nice young guys who are starting out, and and they are just starting out, and they do some really nice stuff, easy to watch really, which is what it's about, informative, because it's about the content really, isn't it? So this afternoon's content is going to be about this little lovely machine, and I'll take you off the stand, and then you can see what I'm talking about. So stay with me. So here we are, we're looking at the famous Sony. Now, I spent quite a long time, let's put that record over there so it doesn't get broken. I spent quite a long time on this machine, because I took all the front off. You remember last time I took this front panel off, and the circuit board disconnects. I mean, Sony have done a really good job. It was easy to take apart, and it's been very easy to put back together. And so I had to change the belts, and the belts I've changed, I don't know if you can see there, but they're the ones that are this one here and this one here, and then I had to put it all back together, and there was a method I had to use for that, and the method I found on here was to make sure that I put the belt onto some of the prongs that were sort of sticking out. Was this whole I don't even say this whole section came out. So I did this side first, and then I eased the belt, because I got some belts on eBay. These are the belts I got on eBay, and they range from 4.4 millimeters to 80 millimeters in length. So I had to, just because I didn't know which one I wanted, I had to sort of experiment a bit. I found the right one, and they, you know, that's fine. So that's going well, and I've now got them in a nice little box. So I did that, and then I got it all back together, and then I started to play with it. But unfortunately, it's still not as I would like it to be, and I don't know why. And I think it's come to the end of the road, really, because I got it just doesn't play. It runs back and forward, but then it doesn't play. And I've used the hand controller. Excuse the wire in the way here. Excuse my French. That's really helpful, wasn't it? Excuse the French there. Sorry about that. I do apologise. I didn't mean to swear. Right, okay, I'll cut that out. So, I'd use the controller here. And then what you do is, on there, if you can see there, you have to press deck A or deck B. Okay. So the two top, these two buttons would play, wouldn't they? For one way or the other, because it's one of those reverse. It's very similar to this machine here, which is my Technics RS-TR313. This worked perfectly. I had this playing the other day, and that has got reverse, auto reverse on both of these. So you can go either play that way, or stop, and then you've got. So this machine works in a similar way, but it's, I think it's confusing itself somewhere, because and I'll show you. I've got a cassette in this side. This side, I've got a cassette in, which is this one, Dennis Roussos. So if I push it onto A, and then press play, all I get is that. And then what happens is, the motors are running, or the motor is running, but you won't be able to see in there. But there's nothing happening. It just doesn't go anywhere. So then if I press stop, you hear it stop, and then if I go forward, it does the same thing. If I press B, if I put it into B, so I'll take it out of here, and then I have to do some jiggery-pokery. For some reason, excuse my French there, it locks itself. I don't know why it locks it. So if I put it into here, and then on B, if I press, there we go, it's running back now. And both motors are, because it runs on two of these motors. There's a motor here and a motor here. One's the play motor, I reckon, and one's the rewind and forward wind motor. And this side is the record and play, so I know it's okay. This side's only play. But all I get is it running back and forward. It won't play for some reason. I don't know why. And also, it seems to have this logic thing where it seems to look for a track, and then, there you go. So, right, so now it stops. So then if I press play on this side, which would be that, if it's that way, which is saying now that way, but it's not doing anything. It's just going jig, 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 back and forward. It's as if there's something else not quite right. And I can't work out what's wrong with it. And I've had this, and I've played with it, and I've fiddled with all the components, made sure that it's all properly pushed in. Nothing's come loose since the last time I took it out. So I just don't know. I've just come to the end, really. So if anyone's got any ideas what they would like to do with this piece of kit, then I'd be very happy to. But I spent about 4 hours on this now, even pushing some of the cogs around. I don't want to take it apart again, because I don't think that's going to do any good. And I think some of the components may. I think some of the transistors on the back here, I think has failed, and it's just telling it mismessaging. So I think the logic stuff has all mismessaged it. So really, that was what I was going to say today, really. But if anyone's got any ideas, I'd be very happy to accept. The amplifier's fine, and I will I'll put that back in the house, because I've now found another tuner. Because remember, the tuner was the other thing. You couldn't see the bar, the wavelength bar. But I found another tuner that I've actually managed to plug it into, and that works really good. That's a Panasonic one I've had lying around. It's about the same size as this. So that's it. So I'm afraid it's going to be a goodbye for this machine. I will take the belts off.
And I don't like failing projects. And I just feel that I failed it, or it's just failed me, and I just don't know why. So it could be something that I'm not knowing. But I'll be looking forward to comments. I'll hang on to it a bit, because somebody may say, actually, have you tried this? Have you tried that? And if that's the case, then fine. But otherwise, okay. Okay, so that's really the end of this video, of this project, really, as far as I know, unless somebody comes up with something different. Just to say also that I bought a really, talking about cars now, the Abarth, my Grecia, my little Abarth 595 Trismo. I bought a really nice couple of Italian flag stickers, and I'm going to decide where to put those. I've made some templates up so I can, and I've copied them so I can cut them up and then put them in places that I think it would look nice. They're meant to go under the front splitter and the rear splitter, but I don't want to put them there. I think I'll have my own little strips of green, white and red, which is what the Italian flag is. So, but I just thought I'd talk to you about that. Hope you enjoyed today's video. I will be doing another one, obviously, when I get next project, because I've got loads of projects. Don't forget, we've got this really nice machine here. We've got the National Panasonic, which I got from the hospice shop, which is really lovely. I've given it a really good clean now. That needs a cassette deck belt. And also there is, excuse the tea, this wonderful, this other Sony here, which is a reporter's machine, which also needs a little bit of help. So I'm hoping to get that on the road again. And of course, it's getting colder, so probably won't be spending quite so much time out here. But if I do, I'll do an upload. Look forward to your comments and everything that you talk about. And see you all very soon. Take care for now. Bye for now. Stay safe and see you soon. Debes brindar amor para después pedir. Hay que pedir.